copyrighted program created by the Rio Grande Oil Company.
Los Angeles police calling all cars, attention all cars, broadcast 92, regarding a murder. Joe Masanaga, a Japanese, shot by an unknown assailant. That's all. Rose and Quirk.
The Rio Grande Oil Company has received the following letter, signed by Jerome Erickson.
As a petroleum refinery engineer, I have followed with interest your advertising of Rio Grande cracked gasoline. I am familiar with the unique processes used in your cracking plant, which are far in advance of those used by any other refinery. I'm glad to testify that your claims of the advantages of cracked gasoline are entirely truthful. In fact, I believe you understate the superiorities of cracked gasoline. But I do question your statement that Rio Grande cracked gasoline powers more police cars, ambulances, fire engines, and other emergency equipment than any other brand. How can you prove such a sweeping statement?
Well, Mr. Erickson, we can prove every claim we make for Rio Grande cracked gasoline. You know that our patented cracking process gives our gasoline exclusive advantages. In soliciting city contracts, we talk with competent chemists and engineers and induce these officials to test Rio Grande cracked against any other gasoline. The result is that the leading cities and counties of California and Arizona now specify Rio Grande cracked gasoline exclusively. So, Mr. Erickson, if you will add the number of police cars, fire engines, and other emergency equipment operated by Arizona's largest city, Phoenix, and its largest county, Maricopa, to the cars operated by such California cities as Oakland, Berkeley, Marysville, Fresno, Bakersfield, Los Angeles, and San Diego County, and many others, you will find that the vast majority of the emergency cars in the territory where Rio Grande is sold use Rio Grande cracked because it gives the best performance of any gasoline they can buy. And now we are privileged to present Chief James E. Davis of the Los Angeles Police Department, who has a word for you. Chief Davis.
Good evening, friends. The tentacles of the narcotic traffic are far-reaching, and the byproducts, crimes of possession and sale of narcotics, range from petty theft to murder. When our men face a narcotic case that entails Orientals, then the task is doubly and triply difficult. For here we meet the craft and painstaking attempts to avoid detection of a drug trafficker linked with the wily taciturnity of the Oriental. But the officer has two strong forces on his side. One is right, and the other, the honesty and civic-mindedness of the Orientals living in our midst. The case you are about to hear was broken because the Japanese refused to be a party to breaking the law of his adopted land. Our policing job would be very easy if the Native American element of the population broke the law as infrequently as do our Pacific and Japanese fellow citizens.
One night, late last April, a Japanese tanker slowly makes its way through the spring fog in the Los Angeles harbor. While the rest of the crew is busy preparing docking gear, two shadowy figures approach the stern, quickly drop two packages wrapped in oilskin over the side. 5 minutes later, a Japanese fisherman reclaims the packages from the oily waters of the bay, and in half an hour, Masanaga, Japanese dope runner, dressed as a gardener, rattles cityward in an old Model T Ford. It is still an hour before midnight when he knocks on the door of a house in Aliso Street.
Ah, you are late, Masanaga. See, there's sometimes a traitor to circumspection, Honorable Okobayashi. I have merely been careful.
You have brought the packages?
As I promised.
You arrive none too soon. Poor thing grows impatient.
Poor thing? He who dictates the laws of Chinatown?
Even so.
Oh, so then I understand you are impatient.
With him, on the other side of that door, is also the great Chong Gao. with two of such men as customers, our lives from this moment on can be one never-ending succession of joyous ease.
Wait for me outside. I will bring you all your money as soon as I have completed the transaction. Honorable gentlemen. He has. Six ounces of morphine, honorable sirs.
We had expected more.
It was a more secret peculiarity this time. But there will be more. Soon.
The quality.
Oh, the best.
Swear.
I swear my honor upon it.
And the price.
$500.
$500. It is not an inconsiderable amount.
Oh, yes. It is not beyond the reach for two or such distinguished gentlemen who are satisfied only with the best.
$500 is $500.
Your venerable Li Po has written. For every prudent one who turns away from the lotus path, there are 10 who will gladly follow it. Others of my acquaintance will pay $500. Four gentlemen.
For fine morphine, your price is fair. We will pay it.
I was already aware that I was dealing with gentlemen of astute perception.
Here's your $500.
And here is your 6 ounces of morphine. May you live 10,000 years. My humble house is honored. Come in, gentlemen.
Please say what we have to say, Chippie.
It is not necessary to encroach upon your hospitality.
Oh, is something wrong?
There is.
Here is the morphine you sold us.
What is the matter?
It is of inferior grade. It is worthless for our purposes.
You must return our money.
Oh, but gentlemen, I cannot understand. I am sure the merchandise was of the finest.
You are not a user, Okabayasha. We are. Therefore, there can be no question which of us is the better judge. Take your morphine and give us our money.
Oh, I'm very sorry, gentlemen. I cannot understand how this happened. I have been the victim of misrepresentation. I was positive the morphine was of the finest.
It may be as you say. It does not concern us. We want our money back.
Well, it is not possible to pay you this moment. If you give me time.
How much time?
What? Maybe 2 days? A week?
You shall have a week. At the hour of the deepening shadow, 7 days from now, we will return.
Matsunaga, you have dishonored me.
Oh, how is that, Sir Okabayasha?
The morphine you brought me is worthless. Sungao and Wu Singh have returned it.
Oh.
With the man their money back.
Oh, but we can't do that. We did not know it is the Honorable Araki in Yokohama who is to blame if your morphine was bad.
Your Araki will do nothing. You know that. We must make good to the two Chinese. You must return your share of the money.
Oh, but I have spent much of it. I have paid the Matsu.
It is done, Matsu.
Oh, but the Matsu has paid the two sailors on the boat.
Then you must get the money back from them. Let them return the morphine to Araki in Yokohama.
Oh, the two sailors are gone. The boat has sailed.
Oh, I hear enough excuses. You get me that money.
Oh, I will do my best.
Something to eat, honorable sir?
Yes. Very much. A glass of hot sake.
Thank you.
And draw the curtains to the booth. If anybody asks for me, you tell them you have not seen me.
Okay.
Save yourself the trouble. We shall draw the curtains ourselves.
Oh, no.
Yes. Also, Fu Feng.
You seem to have been avoiding us, Okabayasha. We called at your house several times since your week was up. You were not home.
No, I've been very busy getting your money.
And you have the money?
No, not so all of it. All I could get was $150. Here, take it.
It is not enough.
But it is all I could get.
Please understand, gentlemen. I am not responsible for this. I acted in very good faith.
Who is responsible?
Matsunaga. He delivered the morphine to me. He received it from the boat. He is responsible.
Then collect the money from him.
Oh, I have tried. Thank you. Oh, but $35. I have added all the money I have. It only comes to $150.
It is not enough.
I can do nothing more.
It is not enough.
But what shall I do?
You have caused us to lose faith.
Oh, I'm very sorry.
Your sorrow, no matter how deeply felt, cannot compensate for our losing faith.
Our honor must be appeased.
But how?
You say this Matsunaga is responsible?
Yes.
Then he must pay with money or with his life.
Oh, he cannot pay money. He has no money.
Then you must take his life.
Oh, no. I know murder.
You must save our faith.
But,
It is very simple problem. You take Matsunaga's life, or we take yours.
I have done my best. I am not guilty. I am a man of honor.
You must save our faith.
But if I kill Matsunaga, they will send me to prison.
And if you don't, a hatchet man will visit you.
Prism is a beautiful garden of cherry blossoms compared to the hot steel of a hatchet man.
And if you are clever, you do not have to go to prison. A hatchet man, if his services are required, will not go to prison.
Oh, gentlemen, surely there is some other way. You are men of honor.
Exactly. That is why our honor must be preserved.
There is nothing more to say.
If Matsunaga is not dead within 4 days, we will visit you again.
Good night.
All ready. Sorry, mister. Oh, take it away. I'm not hungry now.
For 3 days, Okaba Yasha in mortal dread searches for Matsunaga. But no one in Little Tokyo knows the dope runner's address, for while in Matsunaga has no residence excepting his automobile in which he apparently lives. Finally, as the time limit imposed by the two Chinese approaches, Okaba Yasha, trudging down East 1st Street, sunk in desperation, recognizes Matsunaga's car parked before a noodle joint. His decision made, Okaba Yasha clambers into the rear of the sedan, settles down to wait for his quarry. A half hour later, Matsunaga, accompanied by two Japanese, leaves the restaurant.
Ah, it seems we have a passenger.
Yes, Matsunaga.
I saw your car. I thought perhaps you might be driving near my house. It is a pleasure to accommodate the Honorable Okaba Yasha. Get in, my friend. Get in.
At the corner of 1st Street and Boyle Avenue, Matsunaga drops one of the Japanese. Continuing on toward Hollenbeck Park, the remaining trio travel in silence. And then as they are approaching Hollenbeck Park, at the corner of 4th and Company.
Get out, Moto, and help our passenger out. He lives in this neighborhood.
Our tour.
This is your stop, Okaba Yasha.
Please, go get out.
You keep out of this. You got the money, Matsunaga?
No, I told you I could get no money.
You refuse to get the money?
Yes, I refuse. I cannot get it.
Very well. You have had your chance.
No. Oh,
it is your life or mine.
Help, Moto. Help,
what up, you?
Help!
You are his friend. I kill you too.
No, I'm not here.
Come back here. Come back.
All right, Moto, calm down now and tell us what happened after he chased you into the park.
He was shooting after me and hitting the wrist. So, you'll see here.
Well, how'd you get away from him?
I think he passed, fighting in bush. Then when he going after me in great distance, I taking off shoes and going to barber shop of friend, Kokomoto, calling you Brickman.
You took off your shoes. Why?
Oh, not wanting to make any noise for him to knowing where I am.
I see. Now, who was this guy that did the shooting?
I not knowing. Never seen him before. No.
You the boss here? Oh, yes, the police.
Are these two guys in here with another guy about midnight last night?
Oh, yes, sir. I think it might be so.
You know a friend of theirs by the name of Oka?
Oka? Oh, many Japanese have a name, Oka. Okamoto, Okajima, Okahoro.
That's nice. Like looking for John Smith.
A prisoner?
Nothing.
You know Masanaga, don't you?
Oh, Masanaga. Oh, yes, sir. I thinking Masanaga were eating here with these two honorable gentlemen last night.
Well, do you know any fellows with the name of Oka that Masanaga hung out with?
Oh, not knowing for sure. But please, may I ask a question?
Sure. What do you want to know?
Is Honorable Masanaga dead yet?
What?
Say, what are you talking about? Did you know he was going to die?
Oh, I knowing nothing.
Come on. What are you talking about?
Oh, well, I'm not interfering in Chinaman affairs.
Chinaman's affairs? What do you mean?
Oh, well, a couple days ago, I hearing two Chinaman say to customer, if Masanaga not dead 4 days, they kill customer.
You did?
Well, why didn't you tell the police?
Oh, none of my business. I'm not wanting to be killed by Chinaman too.
What was the name of the customer these Chinaman threatened?
Oh, I'm not remembering, sir.
Oh, come on. What was his name?
I cannot remember.
Listen, this is important. Masanaga's dead. If two Chinese told this guy to kill Masanaga or be killed, then this customer of yours is a murderer.
Is his name Oka?
Oh, I'm thinking maybe so he called Oka. Yes, sir. Yes, sir, for certain. I hear Chinaman saying good night, Oka. Okabayasha.
Okabayasha. What did he look like?
Oh, I'm not noticing. I'm not wanting to be killed by Chinaman.
Listen, you've got to remember what he looked like.
Oh, I think maybe he have a round face.
Moto, did the man who rides with you have a round face?
Oh, yes. He having a round face.
How is he dressed?
He wearing cuffs, a gray sweater, maybe.
How old was he, Matsu?
Oh, maybe for he living 50 year on earth.
How much did he weigh, Moto?
Oh, I'm not sure, but I...
California Police State Teletype, broadcast 13 to all points. Be on the lookout for Joe Okabayasha, Japanese, 50 years old, height 5 feet 7, weight 185 pounds, wearing dark sweater, dark cap, fat, round face, known gambler. This suspect may attempt to escape by Japanese fishing boats from Terminal Island, wanted on suspicion of murder.
Chap, how about those prints we found on the car?
We can account for all of them. Either Masanaga's, Moto's, or Matsu's.
Found out anything else about Okabayasha?
Mighty little. You know, this case smells of dope to me.
That's what I've been thinking. I just told Eddie Chitwood about it, and he's working on that angle.
How about the Japanese colony?
What do you mean?
Well, they're self-respecting, law-abiding citizens. That is 99% of them. When one of their countrymen breaks the law, they consider it a personal insult to their race. Mm. Looking glad to help us. Why don't you call the Japanese papers and ask them to play up this story and run a description of Okabayasha? They'll play ball with us.
Good idea, Pat. I'll do it right away.
Patton is right. The Japanese editors are more than willing to cooperate in the manhunt, and their outraged editorials appeal to the Japanese population all over California to look for this renegade of their race and turn him over to the authorities. Several days go by while a Japanese attorney assists Hurst and Patton in their investigation. And then one evening on a lettuce ranch on the outskirts of Brawley in the interior.
Oh, nothing. Yes? Oh, we are having visitors who come to our humble house. Your kinsman, Okabayasha.
I am not surprised.
Hello, cousin Naki. Have you no welcome for me?
You are not welcome here, Okabayasha. You have killed a man.
Oh, even so. I'm your kinsman.
You are no longer my kinsman, Okabayasha. You have brought disgrace to our house.
But I could not help it. You do not understand. It was his life or mine.
You have come far from the old teachings, Okabayasha. Better to commit harikiri than dishonor your name and your race.
But, Cousin Naki...
It is people like you who make it difficult for the rest of us to live happily in this alien land.
Oh, I have no strength to stand here and discuss such things. I am tired and hungry, Cousin Naki. I've been walking many nights. I must get across the border to Mexico. Then they cannot follow me.
The coward's way lies in flight. The brave man chooses death.
Hear me, Naki. Will you help me to cross the border? All you need to do is drive me to collect it.
I will not help you a foot. I will give you no food. I will do nothing for you. You are less than a crawling beetle since you have brought disgrace upon all who once knew and respected you.
Oh, what will I do?
I do not care what you do. If I were you, I would drown myself in the Salton Sea.
Oh, we do not look upon things the same way.
I can say that.
If you will not help me, I will find someone who will.
No doubt there are people in the neighborhood who have no honor, but you will not find them among your countrymen.
Bali Police Department.
You have better send some policeman down to irrigation ditch.
Why, what's up?
Something that will interest you.
Well, what is it?
Two Mexicans going down that way.
Well, what of it?
Another person with them. You go finding.
Well, who's the other person?
Maybe a white woman, maybe not. But you glad for finding.
Well, now look here, hello. Hello! Hung up.
Yeah, what is it, Sergeant?
Some Japanese says a couple of Mexicans are taking a white woman down to the irrigation ditch.
A white woman?
Well, he isn't sure. He wouldn't say if sure. Probably a crackpot. But you two boys better go down there and look around.
Okay, Sergeant. Okay, Sergeant.
Then you promise to get me across the border tonight?
Si, amigo. But first we must have our pay.
Oh, I cannot pay you all in money.
Well, it is too bad, amigo.
But I have 2 ounces of verified morphine. It is worth more than you ask.
That is different. Huh? That is different.
Come back here by these trees. I will let you stand for you.
I don't see no Mexicans. Do you, Ed?
No, no white woman either.
Yeah, wait a minute. Somebody in those trees there.
A couple of Mexicans, all right. And a Japanese.
We better shake them down and see what it's all about.
Okay.
I'll just flash my light in there. Well, boys, what are you up to?
The police
are... Hey, come back here. They're
full of guns, Harry. Let them have it.
Well, we winged one of them.
Yeah, the gap.
You see where the Mexicans went?
No, they got away. This fellow dead?
No, he seems to be breathing.
Now, roll him over. Let's get a look at him. Let's see. Fat face, dark cap, dark sweater. Say, looks like the guy that's wanted for murder up in L.A.
Here's his gun. Spanish 38.
You better get the ambulance to El Centro and have the sergeant send his gun up to the L.A. Homicide Squad.
Well, Mark Clay, what's the dope on that Spanish 38 the Brawley Police sent us?
The gun is the same one that shot the bullets found in Masanaga's body.
See these two slugs?
One's a test shot fired from the gun.
Yeah.
The other's a slug taken from Masanaga's head.
Mm. Now notice the groove.
Never mind the technical explanation, Mark Clay. We'll take your word for it. Come on, Pat.
Well, I guess that settles Okabayashi. The prints on the gun handle are identical with the ones we found in Okabayashi's apartment. Mm-hmm. And the description furnished by Brawley Police matches the description we have for him.
Right. The next step is to talk to the guy.
Hurst and Patton pull out for El Centro, where Okabayashi lies in the hospital recovering from the wounds inflicted by Brawley officers when he tried to escape. It is a glaring hot May morning when he enters the hospital.
How's the patient, Doctor?
Oh, recuperating nicely.
Nothing serious, huh?
No, just a flesh wound. You'll be on his feet in another week.
That's just fine. Mind if we go in?
Not at all. Right this way.
Okay to question him?
Certainly. If you can get anything out of him. He's pretty quiet, Doc.
Oh, don't worry. He'll talk to us.
Hello, Kobayashi.
Who are your gentlemen being?
I'm Hurst from the Los Angeles Police Department. This is Patton.
What police? But for our police wanting Okabayashi.
I guess you know that as well as we do.
No, not knowing.
Pretty hot down here in El Centro, isn't it, Okabayashi?
Oh, yes. I thinking sometime cannot stand in heat.
Pretty cool up in L.A. Nice breeze blowing in from the ocean. I'd like to go back up there.
Oh, no. I want to go out to Los Angeles.
But you're going just the same.
Why did you kill Masanaga?
No, not killing anyone.
Listen, Okabayashi, it's too hot to argue. We know you're dead.
Oh, no. Honorable gentleman making mistake. No killing. Okabayashi feeling no one.
You're feeling too bad to lie convincingly, Okabayashi. Listen, you've been described by Moto and Matsu, who were in the car with Masunaga that night. You've been described by the proprietor of the noodle joint the night the Chinaman threatened to get you.
And we have your fingerprints from your apartment in Los Angeles, as well as on the gun they found on you in Brawley. The gun that you used to murder Masunaga with.
We'll prove all these things in court, and we'll send you up for murder. Of course, if you confess now, you might get a lighter sentence. Anyway, it's cooler up in the L.A. County Jail than it is down here in El Centro.
Well, how about it, Robert Kayasha? Want to come clean?
Oh, what is the hungry dare to do when Fuji's corn is white and the cherry trees are buried deep in the cold, wet snow?
Huh? What did you say?
Oh, I was a sighting tanka by Japanese poet. It having meaning of hopelessness.
Yeah, meaning that you're up against it, huh?
For it seeming to be will of God that Okabayasha is caught.
Well, looks like it.
Very well. I telling everything. I shooting Matsunaga. I having good reason. It's not being my fault.
And so Joe Okabayasha makes a detailed confession to the Los Angeles officers, and as soon as his wounds have healed enough, he is brought to Los Angeles to face charges of murder and assault with intent to commit murder. His preliminary trial is held before Judge Ellis Egan, and Okabayasha, pleading guilty to second-degree murder, takes the stand he don't.
Yes. I killing Matsunaga. I am being guilty for murder in American law, I maybe. But American, not understanding of the laws, Japanese and Chinaman, he have other laws. He have laws of saving face. Cannot break laws. Chinese tell me lose face. Me have to save face for them. Or they kill me. They saving face. Very hard American understand. Very easy Japanese understand. I killing Masuna. But not being very guilty. I having for killing. Or I being killed. It is like Big Bear and Hunter. If Hunter not killing Big Bear killing Hunter. I not being very guilty.
But Okabayashi's ingenious explanation of the Oriental Code of Ethics fails to impress Judge Egan. Winds up the case by finding the Japanese guilty and sentencing him to San Quentin Penitentiary.